morning. This is Dr. John Bennett broadcasting from Miami Beach for Neurosurgical TV. We are graced with the presence of Juha Hernes-Nammi, who's going to talk about his 3+ years in China. Welcome, Juha.
Thank you, John. Welcome, everybody. So I share my screen. Is that okay?
Yes, perfect.
Okay, so I will tell about my more than 3 years working in China, in Zhengzhou, in central China, in Henan province. So I'm working in the International Center for Neurosurgery, Henan Provincial People's Hospital, Zhengzhou, China, since June. 3 years, or more than 3 years. So here is short life story. I was born in Kannus, Niemonen, in a small village with less than 100 people, and now ending up in the largest country of the world, China, with 1,410 million people in the last counting. Why I became a neurosurgeon? They don't see. Yeah, but can you take? So I was studying medical science in Zurich, 1966, 1973, and I saw Professor Kreienbühl and Professor Yasarkil there, and they became my heroes. That's why I became a neurosurgeon, because of them. And then I went to be trained in Helsinki, 73, when I became medical doctor, and then I became neurosurgical specialist 1979, and made also in the same year I made my PhD on brain traumas. After that, I went around the world to learn more. The short periods, I was sitting close to 3 years in the cold corners of the operations rooms around the world. And then I went to Zurich several times to see Professor Yasarkil operate, first time 1982, and this changed my life because I saw him operate on, and I began to follow exactly his footsteps. Before I went to Helsinki from Kuopio, I went to London, Ontario, to Miami to see professors Charlie Drake and Skip Pierce, famous for their posterior circulation aneurysm surgery. Besides heroes, you need mentors. And this was my mentor when I was resident neurosurgeon in Helsinki, Seppo Pakarinen. And here he is with his son, Sami Pakarinen, who is now a cardiologist. He was a good man. So this is Finland. The most left arrow is showing the small Kannus, small village where I was born, and then two arrows where I have been made my lifetime work, Kuopio, Eastern Finland, and then Helsinki, 18 years as chairman, Kuopio, 17 years as a neurosurgeon. Finland is a special country. Females are extremely strong. You see, this is our prime minister at the moment, 2 years now, Sanna Marin. And what we have done specially, we were plugged with aneurysms, and we formed very good databases. First in Kuopio, I made a good database, and then when I moved to Helsinki, Hanna Lehto and Retsai Behnam continued the work. At the moment, last moment I know, there were 18,000 patients with 22,000 aneurysms. And as this is very special database because it has extremely high number of cases, but because Finland is a very small country, 5.5 million people, but very good organization. So we can follow up all the patients until they're dead. So we know the cause of the all causes of the death of these patients. So this is a very special database, and there are many hundreds of publications and many PhDs done based on this database. So I have been learning with masters. Of course, here you see master of masters, Professor Yasarkil, and this picture on the right is from the Helsinki Life course. You see Mika Niemelä, my successor. Late Evandro Oliveira was there, still in good condition, me, and then Professor Yasarkil's best two peoples, Ali Krist and Ugur Türe, and Reza Dasti, my fellow from Istanbul at that time. So this was Helsinki Life courses. I was 16 times in them, and then it was continued by Professor Niemelä, but unfortunately now, certainly because of the COVID time, the life courses went down. After retiring in Helsinki, 2015, you have to retire at the 68 from the professor and chairmanship. So I went to spend some time in Little Rock, where I was also one of the members of the soccer team, but I was like a tree. They were running around me. I cannot play soccer, but I was involved. But the Latino fellows were extremely good. But usually Alicris's team was always winning. And this is Little Rock also. So beautiful surgery there. Alicris doing many cases a day. Amputual skull base surgery, aneurysm surgery, vascular surgery. And this is a beautiful dissection laboratory. Many courses are given there, and excellent supervisor is Professor Emad Abud. And this is now, this is what comes now. Then I met Professor Yasarkil after being in Zurich several times. Then I met him in a meeting in Germany, and I invited to Helsinki for after Scandinavian Neurosurgical Congress, and this is 2001. Professor Yasarkil, my chairman, Professor Markku Kaste, neurologist, and Dr. Sukru Sakhral was with Professor Yasarkil. I know that my hair was darker than now. This was the first operation in Helsinki. When we came to Helsinki from Turku, so I saw two aneurysms. First, I made carotid bifurcation aneurysm, and then basilar artery aneurysm. This is the basilar artery aneurysm in park bench position, and you see Professor Yasarkil is following the operation. It went extremely well, both operations, and he was enthusiastic because our organization was around the same than in Zurich, so he continued to operate on 2 weeks and came then in three years to us. And this was the beginning of the life course. So this is also from the life course. This is third life course. And left down, you see my first contact with China. This was my first fellow in Helsinki. Nowadays, Professor Wu Shen from now in Shenzhen. And he was a great artist, and here he gave a good, wonderful picture, what he was drawing where Professor Yasaki was operating on Helsinki. And you see on the right down, you see how Professor Yasaki is giving everything to for the operation of the patient, making acrobaty with dancing with the microscope to have a good angle. And here he is explaining the participants, everything, and Hussein is assisting closing the wound upwards. So before I became chairman in Helsinki, I went to see Professor Drake and Professor Pieles to London, Ontario. And I was very enthusiastic about their work. I wanted to make a fellowship there, and I went there. But at the same time, Professor Drake retired and Professor Pieles moved to Miami. So I followed him to Miami. This is from Miami 30 years ago. Jackson Memorial Hospital. I was working on the posterior circulation aneurysm material of Professor Drake and Pieles. 1,767 patients with the counting, and then we made a book, and it has the second edition. Of course, nowadays very few people are operating on posterior circulation aneurysm, and this remains certainly the largest series. But the book was by Drake, Pieles, and Hernesheim. It was a wonderful book when it came out, and I'm still proud of it, because I wrote nearly every page myself, and it was checked by Dr. Drake, and we were sitting together and arguing about the fate of the patients. Dr. Drake was saying, this Texas girl didn't have a clonal palsy, and then I tapped my computer and showed that she had, but it recovered well. So Dr. Drake called me computer man. Even I was just a rookie in using the computer. Of course, now the young generation is by far better, and I couldn't learn. I was also trying to teach Professor Asakil computer use in Canary Islands. 1 week we had 1 hour computer training, but at the third or fourth time he escaped and he didn't want to do anymore. So it shows that there are different skills. This is Vinko Dolenz, one of the greatest neurosurgeons in Helsinki life course, and behind him Professor Tanikawa Sapporo is following. And this is here in China, Vinko Dolenz gave to our life courses. And here it is, the habit is to sit around a rotating table. And this is one of them occasions. Here, one more. And this is my good friend, Professor Smiedek from Mannheim, Germany. He came 3 times here to China when I was here. And unfortunately, after the last visit, last summer, he died. He sometimes ate very special Chinese food. This is scorpions. It was extremely tasty and good. Even I don't like so much the Chinese food. And these are also good friends and support. We have went around the world. This is Professor Aki Kawashima from Tokyo, Stanford Su from Taiwan, and the lady is Fitri Suwardi from Indonesia. So now I speak about my presence and future. Professor Xubin, who is here in the audience, is one of my most important persons in my life. He came several times to Helsinki. We were discussing, and he invited me to Hoasan Hospital, and we went also to his hometown, small town or village, like they say here in China. I think it had 3 or 4 million people, so they call it a small city. And here is my first fellow, Professor Gu Shen in Shenzhen. He is going now to retire as a chairman of this hospital. This is recent photo. We came several times with the Esculap Academy, and we're flying from city to city and made life course in one city. This is from Harbin on the Russian border, famous for tigers. And this is Sangdu, Panda City, and the right picture shows how the relatives are in the hospital. They have to be there all the time, taking care of the patients. Before we came to China, we went to Nepal. This, this is the innovative young neurosurgeon, Jack Serian, and his wife, Salona. They are now working in India. This is Jaip's birthday. This was the team in Nobel Institute in Biratnagar, Nepal. So this was the change in my life. I went to Neurosurgical Congress of China in August 2017, and there were Professor Tianxiao Li from Henan Provincial People's Hospital, and then there was also Professor Xubing, Shanghai Hoasan Hospital, and they were discussing with me and invited me to work here. I told that I have promised to go to Nepal for 1 year, but I promised to come back after 1 year. So I think this picture is from this occasion when Professor Tianxia Li and his senior doctors were inviting me to join Henan Provincial People's Hospital, and I promised to come. And then I came here 2017, invited, and then 2017, there was a very festive signing of the agreement. In China, they make extremely festive. There is loud music, and a lot of photos and videos are taken. This is President Gu, extremely effective president of this huge hospital. And this is Xubin, as I mentioned, one of the most important persons in my life. He is certainly world champion in bypasses. I don't know the exact number, but it must be now 8,000 or 9,000. We can ask after this lecture how many he has done. The record is 12 cases in 1 day. We have been told that you cannot hear. Can you hear me?
Yes,
we can hear you.
Yes, we can hear you well.
My secretary was saying that the volume is too low. For Chinese, it's too low. Electricity is down. I can speak louder.
Okay, we can hear you. We can't hear the video. You want us to hear the video?
Yuha, it's okay.
Yeah.
Your voice is okay. No problem.
Okay. So this is my new home where I'm living now since more than 3 years. This is Henan Provincial People's Hospital in central China, one of the oldest regions of China. This is a non-provincial people's hospital. It's the second largest hospital in the world. The largest one is also in Zhengzhou, University Hospital, our rival. It has more than 10,000 beds. And then there are several more neurosurgical clinics, because Henan province has the biggest population of all the provinces in China. This is the hospital complex of Henan Provincial People's Hospital, more than 6,500 beds. But what is important here, there are more cases all the time. So in this big hospital, there are 650 beds for neurosurgery, neurology, and cerebrovascular diseases. And there are 15 different subunits with senior leaders. So as I mentioned, the population is 110 million, and Zhengzhou has 11 million people. So why I said there are more patients, because there are the departments are crowded with patients. There's a lot, big flow, like Yellow River, of the patients all the time. So this is from Sayolis department. So many patients are lying outside of the roads. And I saw that you see here something very special. And here, this is from the Shaolin Congress. More than 100 years, because this is more hospital.
这里藏着人体最深，这是人类试图用人脑移植人脑的极限挑战，洞悉病灶，精准定位，大脑在全新的秩序里焕发新生，药品、磨钻、斜刀、刀丝。 支架，他们也许乏味、枯燥，而又缺少美感。然而，一旦被双手触摸，他们便不再冰冷。而当接近于智慧，注入其中，他们也便有了灵魂。在同一条追梦的路上，我们互为榜样。 相互滋养，倾听彼此心中 坚定而清晰的声音，脚踏实地，携手扛起责任与担当。心有所想，心有所向，科技创新非一日之功，亦非一己之力。我们在时间的步履中整装待发，只为守卫生命的希望。我们在平凡的相遇里热情洋溢，只为护佑托付的健康。再一次为成长积蓄力量，再一次只为追逐的梦想，再一次为了更多人能分享阳光，再一次相约在通往学习的路上。金城相伴，共促交流，志向科技力量。精研医学，人数匠心，书写温暖篇章。因使命而施救，为使命而出发，这不是一时的身份，而是一生的庄严承诺。
So this was the second Shaolin Congress. By the name is Shaolin, here close to Zhengzhou is Shaolin Temple, and there is a big Kung Fu school. More than 1,000 young boys and girls are trained going to school and learn Kung Fu. And this is from my operation room. We were provided with very good equipment. This is very similar setting than in Helsinki, like you, those who have been in Helsinki can see. Good videos, a lot of videos, mobile microscope with mouth switch, navigator, everything is perfect here. Mouth switch also. And my after operation explaining what I have done, sometimes very difficult because the communication is difficult because we don't have the same language. English is poor here. And then came the COVID time. Then a lot of masks were provided here around the world. We made small visits. Here I'm visiting Tai Chi Master in Henan. And then healthcare is extremely good here for those who work here. I've never been checked. So throughout, oh, I had also endoscopic gastrointestinal check, and every year CT, MRI. So this is extremely well organized. This is Yellow River, the huge river, very important river. And then in the beginning, before the COVID time, we had visitors from more than 20 countries. This is a similar map like we had in Helsinki, where more than 3,000 people came. But of course, then with COVID time, it stopped. No one is coming here because there's extremely strong quarantine. If you come inside the country, you have to be 3 to 6 weeks in quarantine. And this prevents every traveling now. So my last traveling outside of China was in Prague 3 years ago. And in Finland, I have been 4 years ago. And this is our operation room. This is a Ping, it's the scrub nurse, extremely good scrub nurse. She speaks English, but we don't have to speak because she knows what is coming. She looks at the screen, at the other scrub nurse, Shenzhen, the same level. And you see, I'm a good student of Professor Yasaki. Here I'm making the gymnastic acrobat with the mobile microscope. patient was in sitting position, occipital AVM, and I had to operate in awkward angles, but we did well with the patient. And this is the team. You see here, I'm not the most important person in this team. Besides me, is sitting Professor Jiangxin Li. He's the leader of the whole cerebrovascular neurosurgical unit, huge unit. And then there's Professor Xu, Professor Bai, neuroanesthetist Fitri Sumardi, Duan, and you see the names here, and then big number of residents and fellows. And there is also a Finnish lady, she's Essi, who studied in Shanghai all his medical studies. And of course, all the guys were very enthusiastic about this blonde beauty. This is teaching in China. Many times you have to draw because we cannot communicate very well. And that's usually this in the meetings, that's big fighting, how to treat the patients. But this is good, and we come usually to good solutions. And what is important here, the patients decide a lot what will be done here. This is special in China. And then there are different ceremonies, birthday ceremony with leaders. And this is very important for them because this man here in the middle is Xiao Li. He's joining us. So we're joining our teams now, and we make a microsurgical team, strong team. I am saying that so. This is very important because Xiao Li is one of the extremely skillful neurosurgeons, has done close to 4,000 bypasses and aneurysms, also big number. His fault is that he's not speaking English, and must push him to speak English. He would be a world star here, but it is good to work with him. He's a good neurosurgeon, excellent, and this is his team, excellent team also. The families are bringing food to the patient. So the families are always coming to the hospital, and they go to buy food and bring the food to the patients. And this is very special, for example, in Helsinki, of course, the patients are provided by the hospital kitchen, the food. But this is different organization. Of course, if you have more than 7,000 patients in the hospitals, it's certainly difficult to organize a big kitchen for all of them and the families. This is patient room. Wife is taking care of the husband, speaking before the operation. There's a big central operation room with 80 operation rooms, and 9 operation rooms for the surgery, 2 hybrid rooms, and there are 3 endovascular rooms for cerebrovascular diseases. All rooms are running late in the evening, but as compared to Helsinki, tiny hospital, the changing times are long because this is a huge hospital. It takes time to transport the patients. 30 beds for neurointensive care, and then there is also a pediatric neurointensive care. And huge number of recovery rooms, of course, a lot of operations are done in 80 operation room beginning in the morning, all kind of operation, general surgery, orthopedic surgery, pediatric surgery. So this needs a lot of personnel and a big number of recovery rooms. I'm always wondering how they don't mix the patients, because the patient names are very similar, but I never noticed that something happened because they are checking everything. So as mentioned, there's extremely strong endovascular team. And this is founded by Professor Tianxiu Li, and he made his own school. He is one of the best endovascular surgeons in China and has extremely strong pupils. So there's a big number of cerebral aneurysms a year, 1,300. So 70% are done by endovascular means, and then the rest, 400 microsurgical aneurysm operations. More than 100 AVMs, and as I mentioned, bypasses are common here because Moyamoya disease is extremely common. So around 600 bypasses are done by Professor Xiao Li's Liming Zhao's team, and their record is up until now. They've made 7 bypasses in one day. And there are a lot of brain tumors, a lot of Chiaretta, microvascular decompression a year, and endoscopic surgery is the main way to do hypocellular tumors, hypocellular tumors. But it's different from Helsinki, for example, that all the spine is done by orthopedic surgeons. So this is research they are not touching, except there is a tumor inside the dura or vascular malformation. And very weird cases are coming. This was an 18 years old boy, had third bleeding from the huge AVM. I wanted to be active like I have been always in Helsinki, but the family, is there something wrong? Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
I wanted to be active like I have been trying to save the patients, but maybe it was wise to give up with this huge AVM, and the family took the patient home and he died some days later. This is another big AVM in posterior fossa. It was skillfully embolized by Professor Su and Professor Bai partially, and then it was resected totally with good result. Because of the special skills of Professor Bai and Professor Su, many central AVMs are coming for treatment in our hospital. Here's one of them. They skillfully embolize them in one or two settings and mainly successfully. So this is, of course, by far better than surgery in these cases. But this is my work profile, outpatient clinic I have to do with my secretary, Dr. Tungsan Chen, because I'm not able to speak the patient, so he communicates and translates and helps me in everything. So this operation room and discussion with the directors of the hospital, case discussions, also teleconsultations, ward rounds, and then this Thanksgiving of the patients. They give that kind of special flags with text I cannot read, but they thank that they are thankful for treatment. And then every year, some doctors get the annual award as best doctors. I got one year, I got this award. So what I'm doing here in the operation room, I was doing a lot of operations in Helsinki, but now I have reduced a lot my operations. I'm doing 2 to 4 personal operations a week. These are mainly cerebral aneurysms, AVMs, and deep brainstem cavernomas. And I have until now very seldom done brain tumors, but I think when we join now with Professor Xiao Li and Liming Zhao's team, so we will get a big flow of the patients for microsurgery. What is special in China? This would kill Professor Yasakil. A lot of noise in operation rooms, sudden shouting with loud voice, sudden noises, speaking cellulars. It cannot be changed, I was thinking. But now in our own operation room, it is quiet because we asked to be quiet. And we have warned not to make any sounds. So some learning has happened. This quiet surrounding makes surgeries more enjoyable. I was wondering why they are talking so loud in China. And this is one of the good explanations. So I heard that the people were working at the paddy fields where they were shouting loud to each other and needed loud shouting so that they could hear, and it still continues when they talk in the cellulars, and especially when the old people speak in cellulars, but also the young ones. So they are shouting in the cellulars. This is very special and always surprised about that. But this is what we do, operator aneurysm, right, left lateral supraocular approach, partial taking hair. Of course, we use skull clamp, but this patient was shaved before, putting in the Sukita frame. We have extremely similar setting here, like in Helsinki, so it is like a copy of that. And this is from operation room. Here again, skillful top nurse, ping, without speaking, looking at the screen. She gives the instruments, and we are working very fast and efficient together. This is Hugo and Rade Balasarte, my right hand. We have been 11 years, so usually Hugo is opening, positioning and opening the patient, and then I continue when we are at the call. There Hugo again with his team, beginning the operation. On the left is my secretary, Dr. PhD Tungsan Chen, standing. And a lot of photos is taken. This is the habit usually in China. This is the anesthesia team, Dr. Fitri Sumardi from Bandung, Indonesia, and Chinese colleague taking good care of anesthesia. And they have big screen where you can, there are many big screens, you can follow the operation. Here, AVM operation, Professor Xu following my operation. Professor Xu is a very experienced hybrid neurosurgeon doing high number of AVMs and thousands of them. Here, Hugo Balasarte, my right hand, originally from Venezuela. Was trained in Helsinki. We have been together 11 years. Then he went to Toronto and then has been in Germany and now 3 years here in China with me. And was elected to be a staff member in Toronto. So he is positioning the patient for sitting position. We are operating this patient in sitting position. We didn't do so many of them here in sitting position, but this picture shows we can do it very well. This is also from operation room. I think this is the same picture I have shown, sorry. And I have counted something. This is China population. It is 1,410 million in the last counting. So it means around 40 to 80 million Chinese are carrying unruptured cerebral aneurysms. To treat them all, it is extremely big thing. So pipelines are expensive, endovascular surgery is expensive, clipping is by far less expensive. This is what I saw. Usually speaking in favor of microsurgery. But because the price of the endovascular surgery is so high, so it means that poor and sick patients have open surgery. And these are my patients, because some people have no insurance or they are poor, they cannot provide those endovascular stuff. And what is special here in Henan, that even young people have terrible atherosclerosis, also young patients. Why? They are eating a lot of fatty food. We call it Mao pork, because it was a favorite food of Mao Zedong, and smoking is heavy. So more than 2/3 of the male patients are smoking. I've seen only 10 females smoking here in China, but I don't think they are smoking at home. So this is the male thing. And pollution is heavy here. It might influence something if the disease is and genetic. So the Moyamoya disease is so extremely common here, and we are studying that what could cause this disease. So smoking is forbidden. I like very much this sign here. Smoking is forbidden, but it doesn't help. Everywhere is smoking, in the steps, even in the toilets of the department. Males go smoking. And then before COVID time, it was possible to go to conferences. I was invited. This is Guangxi province. And this, then there's a yearly aneurysm clip competition in Shanghai. Basan organizing, S-Club Academy organizing. So I've been several times referee. One time as I was referee before coming to China, permanently, Subin was winning this competition. Admission policy is totally different from the Scandinavian countries. So this is wild and confusing. So how where the patients go? When regular patients also try to select the place of their treatment, there's big advertisement in WeChat and Weibo by the medical doctors, and patients go shopping, like we say, shopping, and ask many opinions and then select some of them. Many patients consult the big classic units in Beijing, Tiantan, and Shanghai Huashan Hospital, and many go there for treatment, so they have a huge patient flow. And I have heard that rich patients may go abroad, but I have seen only one patient operated on in Germany. What is special here in Zhengzhou and all over China, follow-up of the patients is extremely difficult. It's not well organized, actually. I consist follow-up is non-existing. After operation, only few patients come to outpatient clinic controls. They go to the local hospitals, and it is difficult to know their fate. So we have been thinking that we could do it with cellulars, because every Chinese has now cellulars, and using the use of the WeChat, Weibo is extremely common. So you could reach the patient and ask their fate that way, and we are planning to hire nurses to do that, but it's very difficult to organize. So communication is difficult all over the China, except some international cities like Shanghai, Beijing, Shenzhen, Guangzhou. Few people and very few neurosurgeons speak English. I estimate in my hospital, less than 5% speak English. So I decided I will learn Chinese. And we had a private teacher 5 times, 2 hours a day, I learned maybe 600 to 700 words and phrases, and I think I can manage. But the Chinese language is so different. Like here is aneurysm, dog my liu. There's nothing similar with the other languages. What I'm speaking, five languages. So I thought I can manage, but I couldn't manage. So after 1 year, I had to stop, because when I was speaking something, nobody understood, because the pronunciation is so difficult. So in China, I am like a child. I cannot speak, I cannot read, I cannot write. What I'm doing, I live in my brain and the experience. And this my experience is totally different from my surroundings. Here I see extremely high number of very skilled neurosurgeons, and the flow of the number of cases is like Yellow River. But what is disturbing me, this low number of sharing the experience in international journals until now, because this high level experience should be published and a good records, but this is not happening. This is because of lack of English scientific writing. So it means that these skillful neurosurgeons, they remain local heroes. They publish their cases every day in WeChat, Weibo, like this, like WhatsApp. There's pictures and videos of the operation, and there's heavy competition of the patients. So this is like advertisement with the WeChat. So I was wondering, can I change something in Henan, China, or in the world? Maybe in many years, but many years are needed. Here's the classic sentence of Kale and Mahatma Gandhi. First they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they hate you, and then you win. So we selected some goals in surgery, no hair saving, to spread that around to China, and then better anesthesia to have a slack brain, head high above cardiac level, sometimes using semi-sitting or sitting position, and then teaching different approaches, which I have been using in Helsinki. The Helsinki book has been translated in Chinese, and I was wondering, it is so small book, but the Chinese writing is so tight, so it is by far smaller than the actual English version of the Helsinki Microneurosurgery book. What I'm operating, brainstem cavernomas, aneurysms, AVMs. These are Chinese ladies. You see the beautiful hair. They have beautiful black hair. And what happens in our hospital? This is the practice now, all over the China. This is terrible for me. This 1982, last time took the female hair away. So this is my practice. This is 10 years old girl, parietal medium-sized AVM with large hematoma. You see, she looks perfect when recovering, and she went happy home and then immediately to school. When you take the hair from the females, they are invalidized long time. The same here, young, beautiful lady after AVM operation, 2 months after AVM operation. The left picture is from my office. You have to carry masks all the time. And this is everyone is carrying masks here. This is very important. Also, young patient with AVM, looks beautiful, is going home with good hair. It is invalidizing to take the female hair out. Patients may show their thanks by giving positive comments. I cannot read what is written there, here. What can I say? What is written there? Something, thank you for your skills. Or yeah, this is this very special occasion where the patient and family goes home. So the families are all the time with the patient here, taking care of the patient, and they usually then go home carrying big number of things they had in the room during the stay here. So what we have tried, to push the neurosurgeons publishing, because there is huge number of rare cases, beautiful cases we would have published in the same week in Helsinki. This minor success. Changing attitude more international, this minor success. Of course, the COVID has influenced that very much. And then we have tried to connect people with international change of experience, minor success. You can accuse COVID time for that, but it is not only that. So it was also before that COVID time we were not so successful. Then with President Gu, his successor, President Chen, and Professor Liang Xiaoli, they hired a group of good scientific writers and researchers to help in publishing huge material of Henan. Professor Liang Xiaoli gave an order that every senior domestic neurosurgeon has to write one paper a year. It didn't happen. It is difficult to push the neurosurgeons to write. What the neurosurgeons do, they love to do surgery, and that's all. They love to do several surgeries and not to write scientific papers. Maximally, they published good cases in WeChat. This more advertisement than scientific writing. Then we made a plan to make research at Henan Provincial People's Hospital. We had a plan to study spinal injuries because of a very big number of cervical injuries, 300 a year. It was not successful. Maybe one of the reasons was the big competition between the different hospitals, not good cooperation. With Moyamoya disease, we have been more successful. Uganra Parasarte, with Professor Sayo Lee and Liming Chao, are doing great work to taking biopsies of the arteries by the bypasses and studying them carefully with histopathologically. I was pushing the people to do database on cerebral aneurysms, because there's a huge number of aneurysms are coming here, also in the university hospital also. But it was not possible. It was not possible. Of course, I cannot read Chinese, so we need people who can speak English and Chinese, and most of the young doctors are not motivated, or they don't understand in the same way the importance of the scientific writing and publishing. They wanted to have international fellows here involved in writing and publishing, but the COVID time killed this idea, so didn't have any, but some came before that time. So what is I'm always saying, English is important. English is the language of scientific world. This one, no one can change. Should be able to speak and write. And what I say to the excellent colleague, like I mentioned, Professor Chayo Lee, excellent neurosurgeon, good skills. He should learn English, and he would be a world star also, like Subin. So with the English learning, even there's English schools, there are very modest steps. actually the nurses who go to these courses, and there's competition in English, so they are speaking better than the doctors. And doctors, what I see, they have even deteriorated in their English because it is not actively used. So, like in Helsinki, we wanted to do organized life courses, and this has been successful. Have been legends and stars of international neurosurgery. Professor Viggo Dolenz has been here, Professor Christ has been here, Kawashima has been here, Stanford Su from Taiwan, and then I was wondering how to teach Chinese neurosurgeons, and then we were speaking with Professor Xupin, we were given webinars, and then we came to the idea that I'm giving the lectures and Xupin is translating in Chinese, and this was extremely successful. We invited the first stars to our webinars, Xupin speaking good English and translating simultaneously, and now in the latest webinars, Takeshi Kon from Tokyo is translating. So once there was 5,000 audience, and this was by Professor Yasaki two times, he was giving a lecture, and we have a total of 104,000 audience in more than one year. We began last September 2020, these webinars, and they have been extremely successful, always Friday, 8 o'clock in the evening. Some people take the videos then during the weekend. So we have had 6 live courses. The first was international because it was not COVID time. Last live course was held in November in association with the Shaolin Congress. There were 1,000 participants and with webinars, 30,000 audience. Shaolin Congress, the name is coming, like I told you, from the Shaolin Temple, Shaolin School, Kung Fu School, where we have been visiting this very interesting place to go, because you see young people, they go to school and train in Kung Fu years after years, and certainly become great masters by this heavy training. So we have been trying to improve follow-up of the patients, publishing instead of WeChat, Weibo, in international journals. It has not been very successful, but we have published some cases. The best person have been here, Hugo Andrade Palazarte, who has corrected the writing of the initial Chinese-English writing, and he has been working a lot with this rewriting and correcting, and this is a very heavy work to do. Then I was so enthusiastic when I come here. We wanted to make an aneurysm randomized study because there's a huge number of aneurysms. So I was speaking with Professor Tianxia Li that so we could make a randomized study, randomize the patients for clipping and endovascular procedures. But when I came here, I noted immediately it is not possible, like we made in Kuopio, the first randomized study in Kuopio, small city, Eastern Finland. So every patient can be traced and followed up all the time. But here it is not possible. It is not possible. And then the cooperation between the different departments is not so. I think it was very difficult to make any randomized study in this hospital because there's a lot of competition how we will treat the patient, and this is not possible in the way like we did in Kuopio. This is the first Shaolin International Neurosurgical Congress, November 2018. This was the idea of Professor Tiang Xioli to make this big congress. I was present in the first. There were 3,000 participants. Giving here my philosophy of neurosurgery. You should travel, going around, and like I say, steal the experience. This is the second Shaolin Congress. Wing Codolence was getting the Shaolin Prize. Besides him is Victor Hugo Perez, and then President of the World Federation, William Kohlfeld from Utah, and me and neuroanesthetist Fitri Sumardi. This is the second one. The first Shaolin Prize became Professor Yasakil, and last year it was Professor Konovalov from Burdenko, Moscow, and then Professor Guido Guglielmi. Unfortunately, they couldn't come here because restrictions, but they gave excellent lectures. And now this year, we invited Professor Spetzler, but this Shaolin Congress was postponed because the increased numbers of COVID cases. Increase of COVID case numbers, I am always wondering what does it mean here. Because there, in China, you have 100, 200 COVID cases a day, and this 1,400 10 million people. And when you look at the other countries, or the even Finland, small country, has when they had 2,000 cases, and now it is below 1,000. So it is difficult to understand, but the policy is extremely strict here. This is one of the life courses. We could all have to be in master of IBASIS, Victor Hugo Perez, doing a beautiful specimen and helped in the cadaver laboratory. First course, then second course, big number of participants. These are all domestic now because no one can come from abroad inside. So 2 years, we couldn't see any of these beautiful places. We wanted to go to Tibet, we wanted to go to Mongolia, Xinjiang. It was not possible to travel. It was forbidden to travel even nearby cities, and it's even very much restricted. So it has been difficult times that way. So when continuing here, I asked in the work agreement, should get the domestic holiday where we want to go. I would like to see also the western part of China. In Xi'an, I have been several times before coming permanently to China. I'm always thinking when I see this Xi'an terracotta soldiers, which is something very special, I always think about my operations. So I think I have operated more than 16,000 patients. So I always think that this one had hemiplegia, this one died, this had oculomotor palsy. So this is the row of the complications you have in your long term 50 years of neurosurgical life. So this is a picture I like in this way. And this, of course, it is extremely great touristic attraction, and they are all the time finding more these terracotta soldiers there. So it is increasing all the time. You may buy that kind of terracotta soldier copy. I had in Helsinki home, I have that kind of kneeing terracotta soldier. This was which city? This is the huge psychiatric hospital. Xi'an. huge psychiatric hospital. I went to see a psychiatric hospital, Qingshao. I cannot even pronounce the names. So, but the hospital was huge, thousands of patients. And we went inside. There was a department for psychotic patients. Here they are eating inside the hospital. And this big psychiatric hospital, they were just out. They were building a neurosurgical operation room. Beautiful. What happened? So they were building, a very nice neurosurgical department, small neurosurgical department with three operation rooms and very nice equipment, like you see. And this is COVID time, extremely heavy time in the beginning. And the nurses were working extremely hard, and also our hospital sent workers to Wuhan, where the main point of the COVID situation was. I was 6 weeks in quarantine. See what quarantine means here in China. This door is sealed, it is opened only once. You get the food inside. And what could I do in the 6 weeks? I began to write my memories. I was very successful and effective in that, because we had nothing else to do. So it was the beginning, and my memories will come next autumn, in less than 1 year out. They are ready now, and when I go to Finland, they will be checked, and then hopefully translated also in large languages, 500 pages of memories of the becoming a neurosurgeon and life in neurosurgery. And this is our hospital. Many guards checking everyone with cellulars, and also the temperature checked. And you cannot run inside the hospital without careful checking. There are everywhere, at every door, there are guards taking care that no one is coming without a checkup inside. So this may be the secret of the low number of COVID cases, because here you cannot have any distance. There's no safety distance. This is how it is. This is our international center, the seventh house number seven. You see a huge number of patients queuing inside, family members and patients. And in the lift, safety distance, what is that? But everybody is wearing a mask. It's very important. Everybody is wearing a mask. Then we have went to some nearby cities to see some attractions, temples. Praying. But this one I couldn't see, because I think this is from Tibet. So it takes time to go there because of the situation. And this is, we have some good friends, and this is one of our best friend, Sasha Boy. So I have been successful in that way, that this is the World Neurosurgery cover some years ago. Now 69 most important neurosurgeons in the world, She also took Chinese, of course, she could sing Dandy, Sami, Yasarkil, and so on, giving condolence. But I was elected here in the north. I'm here in the north. Where's the arrow? Take back. I'm here, yeah, side proof. This is the most northern European country, Finland. So I was extremely taken of this big honor to be in this group with the famous teachers and one of the role of the development research. So I thank you all for teaching, critics, support, and friendship. This is how it we develop. We are standing on the shoulders of the giants, of the former generations, and that, because of that, we can reach higher. This is one of my heroes and teachers, Professor Yasarkil, of course, teacher of the teacher, master of masters, Spetzle, Lawton, Sano, Anikava, and unfortunately, Evandro Oliveira. Died last year in terrible disease, amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. So this is important message. Never forget those who helped and guided you. So I thank you very much. This is one young AVM patient, beautiful young lady after surgery in the dancing group. Thank you very much. Seiseni, kiitos.
Okay, good. Thank you very much, Juha. Look into your life and experience. And you have a lot of people, I think, that want to say some things. Would anyone on the panel like to comment? Ben, do you want to start it off?
Yeah, thank you, Professor Juha. You achieved a lot. You are very modest for your achievement in China. Actually, we have so successful webinars, just as you mentioned, it's maybe the biggest webinar series in the world. The participants, accumulated participants is around 140,000. That's a great number. Thank you again.
Yeah, I have just one moment to mention that Zubin is, I don't know what is your actual number of bypasses now and what's the one day record of bypasses. I have been in Hwasan Hospital recently. I saw how extremely effective the team is working here. So in the different operation room, making step-by-step bypasses. So what is the number now?
Now it's so around 9,000. Yeah.
Okay, I was 1,000 behind you.
Yeah. Now every year, more 1,000, at least.
Yeah, that is a bigger flow. Also in Henan Provincial People Hospital, Sayoli and his team, they are doing now 600 bypasses a year. This is of course only half of that what you are doing.
Dr. Goel, did you want to say a word or two?
Yeah. Of course. You have played absolutely important role in the world of neurosurgery, in the world of technical neurosurgery, in the world of fine micro neurosurgery. You have not only done, you have promoted it, you have popularized it, and you have shown your outcome in various workshops, conferences all over the world. Your contributions to the world of neurosurgery will remain absolutely critically important and will go on giving message of to every young and old and senior and every kind of neurosurgeon all over the world how to do, what to do, when to do, and how to be, how to have humility in your character, how to be humble despite the success, how to have your legs firmly girded despite your head being so high. I think I have personally got great messages from you, messages of love, messages of affection, messages of teaching, and messages to do good neurosurgery. I think I will be in debt to you for your contributions to the world and to me personally. Thank you, Juha.
Thank you for your kind words, Atul.
Any more comments?
Thank you, Professor Juha. For me, it has been wonderful to be with you in three different occasions in China. So you are an example for all the brain surgeons around the world for vascular and tumor surgery. This has been, for me, an unforgettable lecture. Thank you so much. Hope to see you next year here in Mexico if COVID allows.
Yeah, it would be great to come to Acapulco. As you remember, we have invited you. We have the plan to make a cadaver lab, so we have invited you and Madaput to help in forming a good cadaver lab. This is our plan in the future year with President Chen and Professor Tiaxiali, so to make a cadaver lab here. So you are certainly more than welcome as one of the most skilled cadaver lab doing beautiful specimen who is doing about the arteries, veins everywhere, also in the spine. So I'm always wondering how you can take the spinal cord out and then show the arteries. That is big work, hard work.
Thank you.
One thing for Professor Juha, you mentioned that the Chinese version of your book is quite thin, but actually I also joined the translation work for your book. Actually, you know, when the English translated into Chinese, it could be thinner, much thinner. I guarantee we already translated all your English into Chinese.
I have checked, so everything inside, but it's only so much thinner. But so this practical
language.
Right. So it's very very good. It's very.
I also noticed the difference between the word number. Yeah.
Very good. More
developer right there.
Go ahead. Your superior orbital lateral approach now it's some kind of standard approach for the aneurysm clipping. So actually, it's quite popular in China. That's also thanks for you. Yeah.
I was discussing with Hugo Andrade about that. That's because I was opening all the cases myself, so I developed something in the opening. If the residents or fellows are opening, so they are not developing something in the opening of the skull, but because I was opened all the cases in Finland, I opened myself, so I developed very fast technique in that. And so I think this is one of the biggest achievements there. Europe, lateral superior approach, so it's very simple. In Helsinki, where I did many cases, so I was below 10 minutes, I was inside the dura already. Emela, we made certainly the record of aneurysm clipping. There was M1, aneurysm unruptured, aneurysm right side. So I opened and I clipped the aneurysm, and then Professor Mika Niemela close this 25 minutes. If somebody can do better, then we, no way we can say it like no one can beat Professor Subin in the Vibasis or Professor Drake PLS, late Professor Drake PLS in the posterior circulation analysis. So no one beat this series. So the second fastest operation was 28 minutes also with Professor Mikaniemelä. He was closing fast. I asked him when it went so fast that if he closed in one layer, that he was doing a perfect job. But then came the ICG and different interoperative methods, of course, then this takes more. Usually we could do below an hour from skin to skin. Giancarlo Perra has been many times in Helsinki, good friend, many years. You are muted, Giancarlo. You are muted.
I'm muted, yeah. Hello?
Yes, we can hear you more now.
Yes, yeah. Hello.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. This is Dr. Ahmad Fawad Mirzad from Afghanistan. Thank you, Professor Yuha and Professor John Bennett for such a good opportunity for sharing your experience. And we got a lot from your experience. And just I like to know, is it possible to have some chances for Afghanistan young neurosurgeon or for further scale like fellowship or scholarship in your center or other opportunity in other countries that's for Afghanistan people? Thank you.
I had 16 times life course in Helsinki, and when I was working in Helsinki there were more than 3,000 visitors around the world. Now in China, because of COVID time. So I have to say that China is closed, because when you come here, then you have to be 3 weeks in quarantine. And Hugo, my excellent right hand, came back from Germany. He was 6 weeks in quarantine. So it means that it makes actually that kind of training impossible, and it's difficult to get the visas and organize. So it continues. How also this year's Shaolin Congress was postponed until next year, and I don't know if it can be done in the beginning of next year. So situation seems to continue. Europe is in flames. USA, Latin America is in flames. Even Australia and Singapore have high numbers. So we are following that exactly. And I think the strong discipline in China helps to prevent. If there would be not that kind of strong discipline and people obeying commands, then there would be millions everyday cases now. So, strong control and everybody using masks.
Okay, any more comments before we close?
Yes, John.
Go ahead, Arshad. Go ahead.
Oh, yeah, no problem.
Hello, Professor Jua.
Hello, Arshad.
Hi, how are you? Excellent journey. You are very inspirational. Nobody can be your critics. Can I? And we are too small to criticize or being critical about you. You are inspiration and you have pearls of wisdom to give to all over the world. And amazing life which you have given. You are giving us an inspiration to learn more and more, and amazing work you are doing in China as well as in Helsinki. And I'm the student of neurosurgery who is following you every Friday and enjoy to learn from you. Amazing. You are the institution itself rather than just a lecture. It's too small to say anything. The words are too small to say about you. Great.
Thank you. Thank you for your time.
You are beyond words. Beyond words. Beyond words.
When I was working in Eastern Finland, there's a special dialect. And when you give that kind of prize to a person, then he's saying, keukelisse. This means that tell more, I can hear, because it is so great pleasure to hear what you are speaking. So you are giving too much good words for me. This is my thinking. I learned from my father, and then I learned from Professor Drake to be modest. Professor Drake was extremely modest, excellent neurosurgeon, and also good human being, and was always wondering why all the prizes are coming here. But he was, of course, he was.
You people are the stalwarts.
It is good way to be humble, because the world is full of arrogant people.
Okay, very
you can
good.
Never think that you can be very arrogant. Never, never. Amazing, amazing.
It is not my way. Not my way.
Okay,
you are amazing. There is no question. No second thoughts.
Very good. You have, before we close, you I just want to show you a friend of yours that's speaking in about an hour. Vinko is speaking.
Yeah, I will follow him. Yeah.
Yeah, and hopefully, I don't know, it's going to be late at your where you're at, but anyway.
No. It is never too late to listen to Vinko.
Vinko. Okay, great. Okay.
Never too late. He's okay. A great man. Great man.
Okay, you have great working with you, and I hope to see more of you. So, and thank you.
I will go now to Finland, but we will continue in March. I will come back with Subin, then we continue here.
Yeah, excellent. And thank you, Ben and Takashi, for working with you, and thank everyone else.
Thank you.
Sayonara.
Thank you. Thank you, Yuha, again. And thank you, John.
Okay, thank you, Ben. You'll be hearing from us.